Hello dear students, welcome to the third session on admission of a partner. In the previous video, we have already discussed regarding the ratios to be calculated at the time of admission of a partner. It is divided into two. The first one is sacrifice ratio and the second one is new profit sharing ratio. Calculation of sacrifice ratio we have already completed in the previous two videos. We have calculated the sacrifice ratio under seven cases. Okay. Now in this video, I'm taking up the second ratio, that is new profit sharing ratio. Let us see the meaning of new profit sharing ratio. New profit sharing ratio is the ratio in which the partners of reconstituted firm share the profits or losses of the firm in future. Okay, the new profit sharing ratio tells us how the partners of reconstituted firm, reconstituted means after the admission of new partner. So who are going to be there? Old partners as well as new partners. So we have to calculate the new profit sharing ratio of all the partners. So this new profit sharing ratio tells us how all the partners are going to share the future profits in the firm. Okay. Then why the new profit sharing ratio has to be calculated? It is required to be calculated where the partners of the reconstituted firm decide to adjust their capitals in accordance with the new profit sharing ratio. Okay, when all the partners take the decision to adjust their capitals after the admission in accordance with the new profit sharing ratio, in such a case we need to calculate the new profit sharing ratio. Okay, so this is the purpose for which the new profit sharing ratio has to be calculated. Then coming to the calculation of new profit sharing ratio, it is generally the difference between the old share and share sacrificed. Okay, but just like how we calculated the sacrifice ratio under seven different cases, same way here also we have to calculate the new profit sharing ratio under same seven cases. So let us take up those cases one by one. Now in case one, the problem gives the following information. The first one, old profit sharing ratio of the old partners, then share of the new partner, and third one, the problem also states that the old partners continue to share the profits in the same ratio as before. So where these three informations are given in a question, there case one is applicable and you have to calculate the new profit sharing ratio as per case one. So let us see how to calculate new profit sharing ratio under case one with an example. Arjun and Bharat are partners sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 3:1. They admit Chandra into partnership and give him 1/5 share in the future profits. Arjun and Bharat continue to share in future in the same ratio as before. Calculate the new profit sharing ratio of Arjun, Bharat and Chandra. Here if you see in this example, three informations are given. There were two old partners, Arjun and Bharat, and their old profit sharing ratio was 3:1. They later admit Chandra into partnership and his share in the future profit is going to be 1/5. And it is also stated that Arjun and Bharat, that is old partners, are going to share the future profit in the same ratio as before. So in this example, all the three informations are given. So case one is applicable. We have to calculate the new profit sharing ratio by following the following steps. Okay. Here, first we need to assume that the total share of the firm is 1. Okay. Then in the next line, we have to write what is the share of the new partner. Chandra's share of profit in future is going to be 1/5. Thereafter, we have to calculate what is the remaining share of the firm. Remaining share of the firm is equal to total share minus share of the new partner. So 1 minus 1/5, you get the remaining share to be 4/5. Then in the next line, we have to calculate what is the new share of the old partners. Now, what is the meaning of this 4/5 remaining share? If 1/5 is to be given to the new partner, the remaining share of 4/5 should be distributed between Arjun and Bharat. Okay. Now, how to calculate the new share of the old partners? New share of the old partners is equal to remaining share of the firm into ratio of sharing the remaining share. Here, it is given that the Arjun and Bharat are going to share the future profit in the same ratio as before. So, after deducting the new partner share, whatever the share remains in the firm, that should be distributed between Arjun and Bharat in the same ratio as before, means in 3:1 ratio. Okay, the ratio of sharing the remaining share would come to 3:1. Let us calculate now what is the share of Arjun, new share of Arjun. So, how to calculate? Remaining share of the firm, that is 4/5 into ratio of sharing remaining share. What is his share in the remaining share? 3/4. So when you multiply, 4 3s are 12, divided by 5 4s are 20. So you can simplify it further. 4 3s are 12 and 4 5s are 20. So the simplified answer is 3/5. So this is the new share of Arjun. Similarly, we have to calculate in case of Bharat. So Bharat's new share is equal to the remaining share of the firm, that is 4/5 into his share in the remaining share is going to be 1/4. So when you multiply, 4 ones are 4 divided by 5 fours are 20. So 4 ones are 4, 5s are. So the simplified answer here is 1/5. And Chandra's share, as it is given in the question, it is 1/5. So we can then write what is the new profit sharing ratio of all the three partners, Arjun, Bharat and Chandra. It is 3/5 is to 1/5 is to 1/5. Since the denominator is equal, we can directly take the values in the numerator, 3:1:1. So in this example, the new profit sharing ratio of all the partners is 3:1:1. So wherever case 1 is applicable, you have to follow all these steps to calculate the new profit sharing ratio. Then let us take up the second case. In the second case, problem gives the following information. The first one, old profit sharing ratio of the old partners will be given. Then share of the new partner will be given. But it does not state, means the problem does not state as to how the old partners continue to share the profits in future. Okay. So if you leave this point, then it is almost similar to the case 1. Only thing is that the third information, there will be no clarity where case 2 is applicable. How the old partners are going to share their profits in the future, that point will not be there. So in that case, you have to assume that the old partners are going to share the future profit in the same ratio as before. Then if you do that assumption, there is no difference between case 1 and case 2. Which means that wherever case 2 is applicable, where you are given only these two information, you have to write one note that you are going to assume that the old partners are going to share the future profit in the same ratio as before. That is why we can calculate the new profit sharing ratio similar to case 1. Then you have to follow the similar steps as we followed here in the previous slide, sorry, previous example, to calculate the new profit sharing ratio. Okay. For case 2, I will not give any example because the calculation is similar to case 1. Now let us take up case 3. Here in case 3, problem gives the following information. The first one, old profit sharing ratio of the old partners will be given. Then share of the new partner will be given. And the third information, the problem also states the ratio in which the old partners sacrifice their profits to the new partners. So here the third information says the ratio in which the old partners sacrifice their profit to the new partner will be given. Nothing but they will give what is the sacrifice ratio. So in this case, how to calculate the new profit sharing ratio? Let us see one example. In this example, it is given that X and Y are partners sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 7:3. They admit Z into partnership and give him 1/4 share in the future profits, which is contributed by old partners X and Y in the ratio of 3:2. Calculate new profit sharing ratio. So three informations are given. There were two old partners, X and Y, and their old profit sharing ratio was 7:3. Then the second information that the new partner is Z and his share in the future profit is going to be 1/4. And the third information is sacrifice ratio. Sacrifice ratio here is 3:2. So using all these three informations, we have to calculate the new profit sharing ratio as per case 3. Now in the first step, we will be calculating what is the share sacrificed by each of the old partners. What is the formula we have to use here? Share sacrificed is equal to new partner share into sacrifice ratio. Coming to the first old partner X, X share sacrificed is equal to new partner share is 1/4 into sacrifice ratio. Here his share in the sacrifice ratio is going to be 3/5. So you have to multiply that. So 1 3s are 3 divided by 4 5s are 20. Okay. Similarly, we have to calculate in case of Y. So same formula we have to use. New partner's share, that is 1/4 into sacrifice ratio. His share in the sacrifice ratio is 2/5. So 1 into 2 is 2 divided by 4 5s are 20. So these are the shares sacrificed by X and Y. In the second step, we have to calculate what is the new share of the old partners. So new share is equal to old share of the old partners minus share sacrificed. Coming to the first old partner, that is X, is equal to what is his old share? 7/10 minus share sacrificed by him is 3/20. So you have to simplify here. Denominator is not equal, so we have to equalize that by multiplying 2 to the first part, both to the denominator as well as to the numerator. So it will be like denominator equals to 20, and in the numerator 7 2s are 14 minus 3. So you get simplified answer 11 by 20. So this is the new share of partner X. Similarly, we have to calculate in case of Y. So here old share of Y is 3 by 10 minus his sacrificed share is 2 by 20. So here again similarly you have to simplify. You have to equate the denominator. So you have to multiply 2 to the first part here. So the denominator here will be 20, and in the numerator 3 2s are 6 minus 2. So the simplified answer is 4 by 20. So these two are the new share of old partners, and the new share of new partner is already given. Okay. So in the third step we will write what is the new profit sharing ratio of the all partners. So new profit sharing ratio of X, Y and Z is equal to 11 by 20 is to 4 by 20 is to 1 by 4. So here if you see the denominator is not equal. So we have to multiply 5 to the last part here. So both to the numerator as well as to the denominator. So here thereby the denominator equals to 20. In the numerator we have to write the values 11 is to 4 is to 5. So the new profit sharing ratio here will be 11 is to 4 is to 5. So this is how we have to calculate the new profit sharing ratio where case 3 is applicable. Then let us take up case 4. In case 4, problem gives the following information. The first one, old profit sharing ratio of the old partners will be given. Then second one, share of the new partner will be given. And third one also states the share of profit sacrificed by each of the old partners to the new partner. Okay. So if you see the third point here, share of profit sacrificed by each of the old partner, nothing but share sacrificed by old partners in favor of the new partner will be specifically given in the question. Okay. This case 4 is almost similar to case 3, but in case 3, share sacrifice ratio was given. So what did we do? In the first step, we first calculated what is the share sacrificed. Okay. But in this case, your work is reduced because you need not calculate what is the share sacrificed. It will be specifically given in the question. You have to start your calculation from the second step, that is what is the new share of the old partner, and then you have to write what is the new profit sharing ratio of the all the partners. Okay. So case 4 is almost similar to case 3. Only thing is that step 1 calculation will not be there in case 4 because share sacrifice will be specifically given in the question. Okay. I will not give example once again for case 4. It is similar to case 3. Then let us take up case 5. The problem gives the following information. The first one, old profit sharing ratio of the old partners, and the second one also states the fraction of his or her share of profit sacrificed in favor of the new partner. So where case 5 is applicable, only two informations will be given, that is old partners old share and what is the fraction of the share sacrificed by each of the old partner in favor of the new partner. They will also not give you what is the new share of the new partner. Okay, that information will also be not given. Only these two informations will be given. So let us see one example. Jai and Ajay are partners sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 4 is to 3. They admit Vijay as the new partner. Jay contributes 1/3 of his share and Ajay contributes 1/6 of his share. Okay. So calculate the new profit sharing ratio. So if you see this example, only two informations are given. There were two old partners, Jay and Ajay, and their old profit sharing ratio was 4 is to 3. They admit Vijay, but his share in the future profit they have not given. That we have to calculate later in the solution. Jay contributes 1/3 of his share. So out of his total share, he is contributing 1/3. So this is the fraction of the share sacrificed by Jay in favor of the new partner Vijay. Similarly, Ajay contributes 1/6 of his share. That means 1/6 is the fraction of the share sacrificed by Ajay in favor of Vijay. So using these two informations, we have to calculate what is the new profit sharing ratio. In the first step, we will be calculating what is the share sacrificed by old partners. Share sacrificed in this case, the formula to be used is old share of the old partner into fraction of the share sacrificed. In case of Jai, the calculation is Jai is equal to 4 by 7, that is his old share 4 by 7 into what is the fraction he is sacrificing? 1 by 3. So when you simplify, 4 1s are 4 divided by 7 3s are 21. Similarly, in case of Ajay, old share is 3 by 7 into his fraction sacrificed is 1 by 6. When you multiply, you get 3 by 42. Okay, so these are the share sacrificed by the old partners. Then in the second step, you have to calculate what is the new share of the old partner. So the formula is similar to the previous cases. New share is equal to old share minus share sacrificed. So in case of Jay, old share is 4 by 7 minus share sacrificed is 4 by 21. So we have to simplify it. The denominator equates to 21 by multiplying 3 to the first part, both the denominator as well as to the numerator. In the numerator, 4 3s are 12 minus 4. So the simplified answer is 8 by 21. So this is the new share of Jay. Similarly, in case of Ajay, old share is 3 by 7 minus share sacrificed is 3 by 42. So we have to equate the denominator to 42 by multiplying 6 to the first part. So the denominator equates to 42. In the numerator, you have 3 into 6, 18 minus 3. So the simplified answer is 15 by 42. So we have followed here second step to calculate the new share of the old partners. Then let us write the new profit sharing ratio of the old partners. So we know here by following the previous two steps, what is the new share of the old partner? But what is the share of the new partner? That is not given in the question. So we have to calculate what is the new share of new partner Vijay. How to calculate that? So we have to add the share sacrificed by Jay plus share sacrificed by Ajay. Okay. So when we add this, we will get what is the new share of the new partner Vijay. So share sacrificed by Jay is 4 by 21 here, and share sacrificed by Ajay is 3 by 42. When you add here, so you have to again simplify it by equating the denominator. It is 42. In the numerator, 4 2s are 8 plus 3. So it will be 11 by 42. So this is the share of new partner Vijay. Then in the next line, we have to write, therefore, new profit sharing ratio is equal to 8 by 21. Here we have calculated what is the share, new share of the old partner Jay. 8 by 21 is to Ajay's share is 15 by 42. Then is to Vijay's share is 11 by 42. So if you see here, the denominator is not equal. We are multiplying 2. So the denominator equates to 42. In the numerator, we have 8 2s are 16 is to 15 is to 11. So the new profit sharing ratio here will be 16 is to 15 is to 11. So these are the three steps we have to follow wherever case 5 is applicable. In the first step, we will be calculating what is the share sacrificed. And in the second step, we will calculate what is the new share of the old partner. Then in the third step, first we need to calculate what is the new share, share of the new partner by adding the share sacrificed by both the old partners. Then we have to write what is the new profit sharing ratio of the old partners. Okay. Then let us see what is case 6. In case 6, the problem gives the following information. The first one, old profit sharing ratio of the old partners will be given, then share of the new partner will be given, and the problem also states the ratio in which the remaining share is shared between the old partners. Okay, case 6 calculation is similar to your case 1 and 2. There it was given that the old partners continue to share the future profit in the same ratio as before. So the remaining ratio of sharing the remaining share, we assume it to be old profit sharing ratio. But in case 6, they will give you a particular ratio in which the remaining share has to be shared between the old partners. Okay, so that is the only difference. Other than that, all the calculation, what are the steps you have to follow, it is similar to case 1 and case 2. Now let us see an example. P and Q are partners sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 3:2. They admit R and give him 1/6 share. P and Q agree to share the remaining profits in the ratio of 2:1. Calculate new profit sharing ratio. So here there were two old partners, P and Q, and their old profit sharing ratio was 3:2. They admit the new partner R and his share in the future profit is going to be 1 by 6. Okay. Then the remaining share of the firm is to be shared between P and Q, that is old partner, in the ratio of 2:1. Okay, so these three informations are given. Based on this, we have to calculate what is the new profit sharing ratio. So similar to case 1 and 2, what is the first step we have to follow? We have to assume that the total share of the firm is 1. Then we have to write what is the share of the new partner R. It is 1 by 6. Later, we have to calculate what is the remaining share of the total firm. It is 1 minus 1 by 6, which comes to 5 by 6. Later we have to write how the remaining share is shared between the old partners, in which ratio we have to write. In the case 1 and case 2, it was given like the old profit sharing ratio should be used for sharing the remaining share. But in this case, case 6, the ratio of sharing the remaining share is specifically given in the question, that is 2:1. The same ratio we have to write here. The remaining share of profit is shared between the old partners P and Q in the ratio of 2:1. Then we have to calculate what is the new share. New share of the old partners is equal to remaining share into ratio of sharing the remaining share. In case of P, remaining share is 5:6 into his share in the remaining share is going to be 2:3. So when you multiply, 5 2s are 10 divided by 6 3s are 18. Similarly, in case of Q, remaining share is 5:6 into ratio of sharing the remaining share is 1:3. So it comes to 5:18. Then R's share, you can just simply write it 1:6. So in order to equate to the denominator of other two parts, so you have to multiply 3 here, both to the numerator as well as to the denominator. So therefore, the new profit sharing ratio will be 10:18:5:18:3:18. So the new profit sharing ratio of P, Q and R is 10:5:3. Okay, so this is how we have to calculate the new profit sharing ratio where case 6 is applicable. Then let us see what is case 7. In the case 7, the problem gives the following information. The first one, old profit sharing ratio of the old partners will be given and the new profit sharing ratio of the all partners will be given. Okay, so what we are calculating here, new profit sharing ratio of the all partners. But wherever case 7 is applicable, new profit sharing ratio of all the partners will be specifically given in the question. So we need not again do any calculation. So whatever given in the question, that itself can be taken as new profit sharing ratio. Okay, so these are the 7 cases of calculating new profit sharing ratio. So that's it for this video. Let us take up the next concept in the next video. Thank you for watching.